Thank you very much for having me, and welcome to my home.
Okay, Senator, to begin with, we are aware that you just returned from Lofa County. You care to tell us a little bit about your trip to the county? What are some pressing issues you observed as it relates to your people?
No, obviously, again, like I said, thank you for having me, and you are welcome to my home on this Sunday morning. Yes, I went to Lofa, as I have always done. This time around, unlike the previous one before this, I have gone on the issue of the Lofa Road. But this time, I have gone in appreciation of the steering committee and the players, the role they play by winning the trophy. So we've gone to Lofa to present a trophy to our people and to celebrate with them. It was a very good program. Lofians over the years have yearned for this cup. Since 1964, we began annexed to Liberia. We've never won the trophy. We've gone for four finals. The first was with Samuel County several years back, Grand Cayman County, Mosirada, and Bapolu. So we've gone to celebrate in one way. I'm glad that the Lofians accepted us. We had the best of celebration. Our traditional people pray for the players. And then it went well. I mean, it was a great encounter. And thereafter, I engaged with our people. I visited our town and villages. Lofians, in general, were happy for the cup. In addition to the happiness, they were also concerned about the Lofa rule. And then they were also concerned about the delay in the certification of the Senator Eli Brandon Samuka, consistent with the Supreme Court opinion. So those were the issues in Lofa that were at the front burner of our visit.
Yes, Senator, on this issue about the trophy presentation, we received reports from the county that except you that attended that event, all of the other colleagues did not attend. Did you receive words from them? Why did they not attend? Was there any sticky issues in the back end as it relates to the comments that made them do not attend the celebration of the trophy?
Again, I chair the caucus, so by my presence, the caucus was there. We all could not have gone. Though there might have been some few concerns, which is obvious, and in any honor taking, it just cannot be 100%. Some caucus members have problem with the way and manner in which the steering committee conducted itself, the way and manner in which the county authority, especially the superintendent. But how be it, in the midst of all of that, the caucus, they decided that, look, Mr. Chairperson will call, go and represent us. So we were there personally, and we make a donation to the team, in addition to what we've done over the years, or over the months, or over the week. We give them a call to celebrate, and it went so well. I agree with you that now the caucus member won, but like I said, I represented the caucus, and since indeed I'm the chair, but my presence at the caucus was present. Despite the issue we have, we think that to that issue that we can resolve ourselves, since there is no perfect arrangement. And more besides, now that we are the defending champion, we have more to do. We will get back in the drawing board to ensure that those issues that the caucus have with the steering committee, those issues the steering committee have with the caucus, those issues we have with the county authority be resolved going forward.
Now, finally, from my end for now, as it relates to the county, you've been one person who have been advocating for the Lofa Road. I spoke with some individuals who, you know, returned from this trophy celebration. They still complained on the private state of the road. What's the update as it relates to your advocacy in making sure that the Lofa Road is brought to a better state?
The last section, you remember, on the Thursday, the issue of Lofa Road was not placed on the agenda. And then during the adoption of the agenda, I raised an issue that, look, there's a need for us to talk about Lofa Road. And the protest said it was sorry. They have had an engagement with the acting parliament minister. And then she needed to come meet the full plenary. Then when she comes, we'll know the status. But physically, I've been on the road myself. There's nothing much going on to indicate to me that the rogue war have commenced. In the eyes of the ordinary man, when you talk about rogue war, they want to see maybe the aspect pavement, they want to see all the app moving equipment being engaged. And if you look at the length of time that the road project have started, I mean, it's been too long. The road is getting deplorable. Thank God many of the journalists want to look for the solid road conditions. Those who wonder with the vehicles, upon the return, I carried the respective vehicle to all the garages. My two vehicles are still here. I'm trying to sew some form to be able to get to the garages. The Lofa is a challenge. They hope that the acting power minister will come over next Tuesday to be able to brief us before we go for the Easter break as to what is ongoing when you come to the Lofa Road.
Okay, you talk about the people of Lofa asking you the status of Senator Elect Bernie Samuka's certification. And we are seeing this process taking a very long period of time. Bernie is currently in court. What were some of the things that you got from those who elected Senator-elect Bernie Samuka as it related to his delay? There's this debate around it. The government is playing politics with it. He may not get the certification or represent the people of Lofa County.
To a large extent, Lofian feel disappointed. Lofian have over the years felt that they've been treated differently. That's the general feeling. I will come specifically to Baron Samuka issue, then I'll go back to how the Lofian have felt over the years. I did think, like myself, that since the Supreme Court, the full bench of the Supreme Court have not a decision as to the Baron Samuka issue and have authorized NEC to certificate him with a professional sentence, they think that the decision of the Supreme Court will be upheld. They think that one justice cannot undo what the full bench have adjoined. So that's the issue, that's the concern they have. They raise it, they didn't have a feeling. They want me as the senator to also add my voice to theirs. That's the issue. And then Lofian tend to go back a little. They tend to retrospect and say, well, what's happening to us? Of all our maturity, with all our meekness, with the contribution we made to this country over the years, why issue affecting Lofa, it's not placed at the front burner. Some of them have said, look, several years back when the President Tatman died, there was speculation that a son of Lofa who was then chief of staff, General Johnson, a native of Lofa from Zozo, was tipped to be the interim head of state. Of some of that nature, though there's not a cogent evidence to that. That didn't happen because the Lofa people are people who are meek, humble. They have shown it over the years, they got resilience. And then that aside, and then the issue of Harry Fumba Monba, who became vice president to the late Samuel Kayando. Harry Fumba Monba served Do and Labra with diligence, with meekness, with perseverance, with all it takes to be a leader. And then a constitutional crisis ensued when Do died. So there were arguments that when the head of state died, the vice head of state takes over. And that didn't happen too. And then Harry Mamba died in the steward death in the state, the former vice president, a native of Lofa from Kolawo district. Then again, this time, another time around again, a son of Lofa, Chusa Imanbueka, also served Ellen Johnson for 12 unbroken years with diligence, perseverance, meekness. I mean, one time the doing of the diplomatic corps in Liberia, the Guinean ambassador, said that many vice presidents in West Africa need to take an example from Chusa Imanbueka because he was orderly. He and the president went a long way. And the story in West Africa about vice president and president now doing too well is well documented. But for Ellen Johnson Sirleaf and Joseph Imanbueka, that was a perfect relationship. As a result of that, Lofian in the number will always vote for anyone that the United Party put up in Lofa County, whether representative or senator. There were only two persons that broke that record on the late Eugene Farapaka from the Liberty Party that won his representative position in Fuya District. And Yahomo 7, IF2 from the Liberty Party won the senatorial position. Man of that, all the other candidates were from United Party. Lofians supported United Party with all their heart, all their souls, all their resources, all their might. They supported the United Party. And that support was because United Party had Chisa Imamboka as their vice president. Hoping that with that kind of support, one of these days, one of the accession club, at least the United Party, struck Ellen Johnson, who said, oh, will support Joseph Parker. And that didn't happen again. I mean, what transpired for that election is well documented in Liberia. So the thing I think, well, what's happening with us? So they're not too happy. There's concern about that. So the issue of Brandon Samuka, so they tend to say, wait a minute, is this thing calculative? Is this thing intentional? Is this thing against us? So in my earnest opinion, I think as a country, we need to look at it critically. And we need to take the necessary step to ensure that we de-escalate and that the Brandon Samuka issue should be handled expeditiously so that the wishes of the people of Lofa can be met. That's the feeling I got from Lofa.
Stay with the Brandon Samuka's issue. There's this Supreme Court ruling that Brandon is a convicted individual, meaning he should not serve the good people of Lofa County. Lofa should not have a convicted individual serving them as senator. That's the debate around it. And you also preach on equity. You talk about corruption. So what is the difference? How can you differentiate yourself from a convicted person serving the people of Lofa and also defending a free, corrupt society?
On a sure note, Lofian, in their number, they didn't have a problem with what the Supreme Court did. When Brandon was accused, investigated trial, Lofians, they didn't resist anything. The only concern Lofian has is that, look, you've come up with a ruling, the Supreme Court have come up with a ruling and said, look, you convict him, but we'll give you a suspended sentence. And then, since you're not a flag rigs, you can take your seat over a period of time, commitment should be certified. Before then, 50% should be made available. And then you give it 6 months. So in my election-related issues, prior to this election, the Chief Justice has said that election-related issue will be given preference. And I again honor our law to the certain number of days that election issues should stay for, not less than 30. And you see the Brandon Samuka issue has dragged on. So let's leave the 2 minutes of the Supreme Court opinion. All of you. Lofi are not asking for anything so much. But if you don't leave the 2 minutes of the Supreme Court opinion, then anxiety is created. Never does set in. Lofi are becoming a thing, but what's happening? Impatience set in. And then when people who are meek, humble, and so orderly, and you start to push them to the wall, they may act in ways and manner that they would not have done on a normal condition. So Lord, not create a condition for Lofa to feel indifference. Let's give Lofa justice.
Top point, sir. There's no other opposition political party, the Movement for Progressive Change. If you may be aware that this political party has filed an injunction against the certification of Brandon Samuka. Are you aware? And if yes, what is the stand of this political party taking the rule of law against these candidates from Lofa County?
Under our legal jurisprudence, the issue that borders on standing. Does NPC have standing? Is NPC injured as a result of the Supreme Court opinion? If the issues are certified, then we can be able to answer that question. And I do not know if the injunction, the fire, came before or after the Supreme Court opinion.
After.
So the Supreme Court already come up with an opinion. And anything the Supreme Court come up with, they are the final arbiter of legal issues, especially the full bench. If the full bench make a determination, I think we should adhere to it. And experience will tell us that you don't want to keep conducting yourself in ways and manner that will suggest to a particular group of people that they are targeted. So, Liverpool have made a decision. We interpose no objection to the Supreme Court opinion. We are law abiding people. Lofians are law abiding people. We represent the interests of the Lofa people. They have told all that they feel that justice has not been served. But a decision as to the ruling on Browning is made or has been made, they think fairly enough that that decision should be upheld. He should be certificated, start his commence job along with me so we can represent the local people. In the event he fulfilled the directive or the opinion of the Supreme Court, they are remedy at law. The sentence, the conviction is conditional. So if he does not meet it, then another action awaits. And then no one will say you target him. But Supreme Court, the full bench, rule in this manner. And they want justice. It's in the other way around. So Lofians too, who don't understand the ramification of the law, tell you about Senator Zago, Lofa Legislative Caucus, what are people doing? So it is but fair that they know represent their legal interests and also represent their political and professional interests. This is why we've been law abiding. As chair of the caucus, we call on our people to remain law abiding. And you see that call on comment to fast track and hasten the issue involving Baron Semba so that Lofa kind of people can feel certified. I have told you how the fee dating back to Tottenham, Iraq, dating back to Dothan, dating back to Elgin, and then they think they've come so close, but yet too far. And they're not blaming on anybody. But all they are asking for is justice.
Now, Senator, let me just interject a little bit before we go back to James. You still, on the issue about the MPC, you asked a question whether the MPC has a stand.
Standing, yeah.
Yeah, they have a standing in this entire process. What's your view on it? Do you think they have a stand in it based on what you see?
We can be preempted now because it's already moot in my mind because this is already made. Because I actually want to generally ask my action because I've been in and out. And the general has told me that the Supreme Court already come up with a decision. So the decision is already made, you come, in my mind, it's moot. But again, it's open to debate. Normally, when you take a court action, two things, either you represent a party litigant, or maybe if you are injured, and then it puts you in a position to have standing. Do they have standing in this case? And Lofians are saying, like I said, obviously, at the onset, we just want justice. And this time, we want justice expeditiously, because we think that the whole thing about certificating the Senator Lofa County had dragged on for too long. Lofians are becoming impatient. Anxiety is setting in, uneasiness. And you don't want for it to escalate to a point where it will go into a full-blown confusion and conflict. We are peace-loving people. Lofians generally are humble people. Meekness is part of us. This is why collectively in Lofa we have one word called Toyin, Togi, me too. We are truth telling people. We are humble people. But you can't keep pressing a humble man down. One of these days he may want to bounce back. And we don't want to arrive at that stage. We don't want you to know that it's Lofa versus the entire Republic of Liberia. No, it's not that way. All Lofa is asking for is justice. And justice will be served timely.
It is justice is that you and all of the fans are calling for the certification of Bernie Samuka based on the previous ruling from the Supreme Court, right?
Obviously. I mean, we're asking for justice. The Supreme Court has come up with a position, and the entire bench, not just one person. So we're saying that let the justice opinion, let the Supreme Court opinion be upheld.
Okay. Yeah, basically, ahead of just the certification program, and still the probation still in making, and there's been a lot of attack in recent time that the premises, the National Elections Commission compound, according to them, that their compound, they witnessed an arson attack, the throwing of petrol bomb, and there was also claims from the Associate Justice Joseph Nambwe of his home being also attacked as a result of a petrol bomb or being thrown. And all of these things are also coming in where there's still this certification of the senator elect of Lofa County still lingers, and then there has been a lot of threats that have been issued. What specifically have you to say with respect to what has been happening?
I think we regret the throwing of petrol bomb. It's uncalled for, it's unsavor. There should be, I think those who are involved, they should meet the full weight of the law, and I hope the security agencies and intelligence company will be able to gather the kind of evidence they need, put the puzzles together, and look at the modus operandi of those involved, and be able to determine who may have done it. But I think they need to be a little bit meticulous, they need to be a little more exact, they need to be focused, they need to ensure that they put the raw data together, analyze the raw data, so that when you make an accusation, you can be able to prove it. Like I said, it's condemnable. I've been a security actor myself. I will not endorse such a behavior. But at the same time, too, want to call on the government to fast track this investigation, so that others will not capitalize on maybe the dissatisfaction of the Lofa people to make it appear like someone from Lofa somewhere somehow has a hand in this. Lofa is far from that. We are a professional group of people. Whatever university, colleges, post graduation, Lofians are the highest people. We all of it. We're not going to get involved in a disorder manner and form. We are all of the people, and we're going to abide by the rule of law. Why abide by the rule of law? We ask for justice. Let justice be served us. Let us put this Brandon Samuka thing behind so that we progress and develop this country.
Yeah,
to a point, I think we also talk about the recent waves of discoveries of armed robberies and as well as cops, you know, looking at the security sector of the country, where you've seen a couple of people being found dead. I mean, and you had a little bit of an idea when it comes to how the security of the country should be like. Specifically, what do you think you can tell the Liberians, or what is that should be necessary to be done?
It's a concern to find that there's an increase in armed robbery. It's a concern that you woke up, you see maybe questionable death, and that's a challenge to our security sector, and we hope they can raise up to it. But if you follow my involvement for a long time, I've said again and again that we have a challenge when it comes to our security sector. We've not met our benchmark. When the international partner leaving the country after having been engaged for the number of years, make a projection along with the security actor that by now we should have had a law enforcement, who is the first line of defense, we should have a strength of about 8,000 plus a man. The military, who is the second line of defense, and that provide the exterior and protection, should have been 5,000 plus a man. Are we there yet? No. We adrift those numbers far below. So I think our civil sector is overstressed. And as such, we need to take sound political decision not to further overstress the security sector that is already overstressed. The overburden, they've not reached the targeted projection. They lack the instrumentality to work with. And then certain, they got low morale. There is not what you call esprit de corps. Esprit de corps is that way in which security institutions work together, provide each other with intelligent information. Now, in the midst of that, we seem to be not taking good political decisions. When you don't have political stability, it undermines security effectiveness and efficiency. So I think we need to have more political stability so the security can focus on actual issues and not political related issues. The security should be focused on how they will put the puzzle together, how they will be able to cultivate police public relationship to be able to get the kind of information they need so that they can be proactive and offset some of the armed robbery that will occur. When the police, who cannot be all over at the same time, there is no law enforcement in the world that will be omnipresent. Omnipresent in law enforcement meaning you somewhere all of the time. That can only be done in theory. That can only be done if you have a partnership with the ordinary people, the community. So if the police is less involved in issues that are political related, or law enforcement institutions are less involved in political related issues, if political decisions are not made in a way and manner that will overstretch them, they can focus their attention on the core issues. The core issue is to create an enabling security environment so that investors will feel satisfied, so that Liberians can feel good, so that we don't need to, or don't need to, not many Liberians will be able to afford to get current, to get light. So then, if we make good political decisions that keep the stability, law enforcement institutions will focus on the core issue that they were created for.
Okay, so with in relation to this similar Brennan Samugai issue, and there have been a lot of things associated with it, and specifically from the Secretary General of the opposition United Party, and this is why he wrote, he said, "Dear National Elections Commission, we understand the plot, but try it and you will see what going to be the end result." And predicated on this post, Moore has been invited by the Liberian National Police, has been declared a wanted man. And then also in recent time, on the appearance of one of their colleagues from Lofa County, the representative Francis Yumaling, made similar threat, especially bullets on the certification of Brandy Samuka, saying that if Brandy is not certificated, that could also lead to an interim government, specifically with the CDC. And on that basis, he's also been invited by the National Security Agency. With all of these comments that have been associated so far coming from folks within the opposition, what have you to say with respect to that?
I think the CPP have taken a position, and we stand by that position. Mo Ali, obviously the Secretary General of the United Party, a party from West Kamet, Brandon Samuka. And understandably, one of the member of the Lofa Legislative Caucus, they said to have made a comment. I have not heard it myself. I would think that like Winston Churchill once said, they rather jaw jaw than war war. So to have jaw jaw is to ensure that we all are treated equal. But again, that will in no way justify anyone getting involved in conduct or action that will undermine the peace of this country. Therefore, I said earlier that we need to fast track issues involving running certification so that you de-escalate some of the tension in the country. The kind of political decision we take point to the kind of security environment we have. So I would think that the Supreme Court decision need to be upheld. The certification of the Senator elect should go ahead. And then if within the time frame that the Supreme Court came up with, those conditions that is set, if they are not met, understandably, if another action is taken, Lofian will say yes. At least the Supreme Court opinion was upheld. I don't support the throwing of petrol bomb. I condemn it. It's uncalled for. It's uncivil. We've had our own experience. We went through war years. I remember just after the war, what happened on Kill Street with Larry. Petrol bomb, don't pick and choose. You may throw it, you don't know who will be there. So I would want to challenge and admonish the security institution to be diligent, to be steadfast, to be thorough, to be more involved. Let them analyze the informations. Let them gather the kind of facts they need to gather. Let them put the raw data together. Let them visit the various scene, look at how it was conducted, that is the model operandi. Let them talk to witnesses. Let them do what you call long-term investigation and not just jump to conclusion. I would think these kind of issues need to be thoroughly handled by professional people, not amateurs, so that when they come up with a conclusion, at least more conclusion need to be discussed. Years back, when I in law enforcement, the kind of issue when they transpired, what happened is that discussions are held, those facts are brought, they are verified, analyzed by the technicians before an invitation or the arrest is done. I don't think we need to hasten it. I don't think we need to make it look that it's the bread and butter issue for now. We should do more background investigation and then let the political actors to get involved so discussions are done, so that action that will be taken will be seen to be action that will be transparent, fair, and orderly. That's my opinion on that.
Yeah, so now let's talk a little CPP politics a bit. Of recent, there have been this debate about who becomes the standard bearer of the CPP. I want event your kinsman, former Vice President Joseph Boakai, clearly stated that he's going to head the CPP ticket. It was the last graduation of the Cotito. And then when Mr. Alexander Cummings had a retreat of the ANC in Buchanan, he also brushed his ambition to head the ticket of the CPP. There are some people who have the view that it's too early for people to be coming up to talk about, or you know, whether they want to help the CPP or not. And some people say they reserve the right to come out to, you know, state as to whether they want to help the CPP or not. What's your view in regards to that?
Everyone that form a political party want to lead. So they have the right to say it. But the CPP got our own framework document, a document that myself was part of it, we crafted it. This year, 2021, by the end of this year, a determination as to who had the CPP will be made. So, understandably, when those four major actors within the CPP, the ALP, the ANC, the United Party, and my party, the Liberty Party, when any of the candidates feel strong that they can have the CPP, they have the right to, but a determination as to who had the CPP will be made before the end of this year.
How?
Oh no, we will have delegates from all of the constituencies, delegates from all the districts. We will converge at a venue to be decided upon, whether it's in Lofa, whether it's in Nimba, whether it's in Bon County. And then the necessary convention will be here. That will be characteristics of a normal democracy, so that a candidate can issue that will better represent the aspiration of the Liberian people in the midst of what is transpiring. Liberian people want to change. And the CPP, in my earnest opinion, is sensitive to that, though there are challenges. But among actors within the CPP, there are those who they consider forerunners. If you actually work within the CPP, and then and the CPP have to be sensitive to the plight of the Liberian people. The CPP will not operate in vacuum. I mean, if you do a sampling of opinion, if discussing with our people is anything to go by, if appearances and the applause that they receive is anything to go by, if program that we have organized and attended, when needs are called, they will receive the biggest applause. If experience is anything to go by, the CPP will make a determination. And there are men within the CPP who think that Chisa Boga stand a better chance. There are some who think that the other TD stand a better chance. So that determination will be made, and the Liberian people will be factored into that decision. That decision will not be void of the Liberian people's aspiration, dream, and hopes.
One of the standard bearers in the past, in the CPP has already said clearly about Mr. Benonayu that he will support a Joseph Boakai, you know, standard bearership of the CPP. What's your take on that? So, do you want the Joseph Boakai standard bearership?
Well, obviously, and again, I may not be seem to be like I'm being biased or I'm being troubled. But if the four candidates, because one of the things that we want to use is to ensure that the four candidates among themselves, and to just fast track the process, the four candidates among themselves will go in and isolate the area and make a determination. That will save all time and resources and money. So we don't have to go through going to all of the districts, all of the constituencies. When the four of them determine who they want, we're going to honor it.
You.
So wait a minute. So no, I didn't say chairpersons. I know what chairperson now. Mm-hmm. I mean the Senate bearer, those who are our political leaders.
Yeah.
So you have Joseph Yuma Bweka, you have Ben Nayire, you have Alexander Cummins, you have Yomli Kanga Lawrence. So now four of them, you said one has said openly that they're going to support Joseph Bweka. So he has gotten one. Mm. So you have gotten half Obo now.
Yeah.
He himself and that person.
So two others, Yomli Kanga Lawrence.
And the ANC. Mm. So if the decision that the ALP Stellenberg have said, if he meeting it up to the end of this year, then the most likely who that time may go Joseph Bweka way. I said the most likely who, if it doesn't change. It is also hope that again, among themselves, a determination as to who become the vice running mate will be made. So, when that determination is made by the vice standard bearer, then they will also be able to work out a vice standard bearer. If that determination as to a standard bearer is made, then they will work out a determination as to the vice standard bearer. If the processes do not come out the way and money we is envisaged or the way it's planned in the CPP framework document, then an election of the delegates would be the next route to take.
For instance, what's the relationship between you now and your party, the Liberty Party, and your chairman vis-a-vis Musa Ability?
Oh, I'm still a member of the Liberty Party as I've always been. I'm not gonna leave my party. I come in with too much in the party. This is a political institution and I'm still a member of the Liberty Party. I think I got a good relationship with everyone in the party. The grassroots, the ordinary people, those who made determination, those who got the voices, those who got the count, I still consider me a strong voice in the party. So I got a strong relationship in the party.
Senator, you don't use the word, I think. That says another, it has no good certainty in terms of your relationship.
We say, I think.
You just use the word.
Oh, no, because human beings are evolving. It's not a situation where you're going to pull hydrogen and oxygen together, you're going to get water. It's too old. So, no matter whatever you do that, if you go to my own town, Sinoloma, or you go to Yenemolao, you pull hydrogen and oxygen, it give you water. But if you put 2-3% together in one town, and then 1 year later you put them together again, it may change. So human beings are evolving. This is why I say I think that I got a good standing within the party. I serve well. My record as to the chairmanship of the party is well documented. And since you want to, when I became chair of the party, we all know we were high hit. The morale was low. There was no euphoria associated with politics. We've been defeated, we were devastated. We raised the issue, we went to the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court came up with an opinion and said the issue we raised were not egregious enough to overturn the result. We accepted it and we'll move on. And I took over at the time where, that moment, I took over up to most recent when I stepped aside for the survivability of the party.
Okay, let's look at the same CPP ticket. You are no longer chairperson of any of the parties. So, meaning you are, by the law, I think you should be a high-ranking member within the CPP. And we are going to election in 2023. You as an individual and a senator of Lofa County, who do you want? Let's forget about the voting. Who will you be campaigning for to hear the CPP ticket? Let's be fair. Let your followers, the people in Lofa, let them know before the time. Who do you really want to see as the standard bearer or the head of the CPP ticket? Let's be fair to them.
And I like the question, who do I want? Mm-hmm. So what I want, we're not who around the Liberian people want.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the Liberian people from my own engagement, mm-hmm. the opinion I'm getting from the opposition camp is that the thing that Joseph Imaboka is preferred. That is the feeling that I'm getting from the Labyrinth with my own engagement. Mm-hmm. And I interpose no objection to that.
So you support a Joseph Boakye ticket?
Obviously, I do support a Joseph Boakye ticket.
Why are you not going for a party? You're still a barrier.
We want to win. Mm-hmm. We want to win. We want to win an election. We have probably the strongest candidate ever in the history of border politics in Councillor Charles Walker-Bronski.
Okay.
We did all we could. We projected Councillor Bronski on three different occasions. We did not win. We took our best moment with the last election to the all who saw the Liberty Party. That was our best performance. It reminded me of the 2005 performance of Charles Bronski and then 2017. So we've gone three different times. If we are to win, let us be sensitive to what the Liberian people are saying. And if you have followed our border politics, if you have followed the environment, if you have followed Liberian, generally, the thing that he comes in with a lot of experience. He comes in with 12 good years of being a vice president. Many vice presidents can become good presidents. Many vice presidents can become good president. So it is within that framework that we think that he should be preferred. And if he is, definitely we'll support him.
Okay, Senator, so thank you. Unless maybe you want to
add to. Yeah, just to zero in on Lofa County, some of your developments. How is your activities there?
I think our activity is good. You know, in the story of the hunchback man, when the hunchback man died, all the hunchback would look at it and see how they bury the hunchback colony. So the past election have been a challenging one. We saw almost our colony not returning. So it informed our engagement. The only thing you guys won't see me doing, you won't see me most often in the chambers. So it won't appear like I'm deliberately absenting myself. But you'll be assured that I'll be running back home. My country is huge and large, you know, six ethnicity, non-district, the roads are a challenge. So Lofian, to a large extent, are very, very concerned about the issue of the road. So my last word that if you don't see me often in chambers, know that if I'm not at ECOWAS, I'm spending some time in Lofa. And then the issue of Brian Samukami.
Spending some time in Lofa, getting prepared for a re-election.
Indeed. again, so I'm hoping that we can fast track the Brian Samukami issue. So that at least the two Lofa chairs won't be vacant. Because if he's not certificated and seated, and then I'll be running the Lofa, you have a situation, the entire Lofa will not be represented. And that'll be a disservice to almost 400,000 people.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.